In this video, we're looking at a projectile launch from an initial height of 45 meters, and the launch velocity actually points below the horizontal, so there's some amount of initial downward velocity. We start the problem by decomposing the initial velocity vector into its x and y components, and that vx component is going to be a 40 cosine of 25, and when I run the numbers on that, that's approximately 36.3 meters per second. Again, the y component is downward, and that initial y velocity is going to have a magnitude of 40 sine of 25. And when I run the numbers on that, it comes out to 16.9 meters per second. Now keep in mind, that's a magnitude. And when we plug into the kinematics formulas, it needs to carry a minus sign because it's downward. Now to get the flight time for the projectile, we have to ask ourselves, is this a vertical question or a horizontal question? And what I know at the final position for this flight is the y coordinate, that's zero. Assuming, of course, that we use the standard origin of coordinates, which would be down at ground level, right below where the projectile was launched. So we write down the kinematics equation that describes the y position as a function of time. And I've already plugged into this that the acceleration in the y direction is negative g, in other words, a downward 9.8 meters per second squared. And my final y position is zero. And here's where it's important to remember the minus sign on the initial y velocity. So it's initially downward, so I have a negative 16.9 meters per second times t, and then half of 9.8 is 4.9. So I have a minus 4.9 meters per second squared times t squared. So this is a non-trivial quadratic equation, and we need to solve it by using the quadratic formula. I would prefer to do that with a positive coefficient on the quadratic term. So I'm going to move every term to the other side of the equation. Now we're ready to plug into the quadratic formula, where a is 4.9, b is 16.9, and c is negative 45. If you prefer to use an algorithm for this, that's fine, but I'm going to show the long way, just for those of you who need to show these steps in your class. So t is going to be negative 16.9, that's negative b, plus or minus the square root of 16.9 squared minus 4 times 4.9 times negative 45. So we've got a double negative on that second term, making it positive. That's all divided by 2 times a, which is 9.8. When I run the numbers on the square root part of this, I get a negative 16.9 plus or minus 34.2, all divided by 9.8. Now we want to keep the positive solution here, and that corresponds to the plus in the numerator. And when I take negative 16.9 plus 34.2 and divide the result by 9.8, I get a flight time of 1.76. seconds. In part B, we want the impact velocity of the projectile. So that means the final velocity when it hits the ground. And I want to express that in polar form. So our final velocity vector looks something like this. And that carries a downward component together with a rightward component. And that's the final y velocity for the downward component, final x velocity for the rightward component. Now the low-hanging fruit here is that the x velocity never changes for projectile motion, provided we're ignoring drag forces. So that final x velocity is already known. That's 36.3 meters per second. Then to get the y velocity, we have to factor in how much gravity has sped up the downward velocity. So we use the kinematics equation that describes velocity as a function of time, plugging in negative g for the acceleration. And our initial, again, we need a minus sign on that, with 16.9 meters per second downward. And then I have a minus 9.8 times t, where t is the flight time, and that's 1.76. And when I run the numbers on this, I get a final y velocity of negative 34.1 meters per second. So we plug these into our triangle, 36.3 meters per second to the right, and a magnitude of 34.1 meters per second in the downward direction. And then our goal here is to express the impact velocity in polar form. And that means we need a magnitude and a direction. And I'm going to label the angle of the impact with respect to the horizontal. So it'll be a number of degrees below the horizontal. Well, that angle theta below the horizontal is the same as this angle theta in the triangle that I sketched. And I'll wrap things up by getting the magnitude of the impact velocity using the Pythagorean theorem. That's the square root of 34.1 squared plus a 36.3 squared. And that gives me approximately 49.8 meters per second. And then the angle is given by an inverse tangent. So the way I labeled the angle, that's the angle whose tangent is 34.1 over 36.3. Just following our usual conventions, we're not including sines on those legs in order to get the angle. We're always going to express this as an angle between 0 and 90 degrees, and then you can refer to the diagram to figure out the direction. In this case, it's the angle below the horizontal. When I run the numbers on this, I get an angle of 43.2 degrees, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.